right, so I'm just gonna do some videotaping and upload these videos because we were having difficulty with the Wi-Fi reception, and your girl is not gonna pay $80 per day to get internet, okay? So I'm just gonna walk around and show you all some of these quilts. I know your girl's rolling on a budget. Ooh, got a zipper in a quilt. Very pretty. This is Zipping Up by Elaine Foster. Don't Suppress My Vote by Yvonne Little. John Lewis is by Janice Daniel. Over here we got Good Trouble by Inez Bentley. And this one here is Light by Tanya Heldman. This quilt here is Reflection of the Past by Alethea Chisholm. Well Deserved Medal by Brenda Shelby. And Remembering John Lewis by Vicki Lord. And I'm talking low because there is somebody doing a presentation around this corner.
But that's where the chickens come from. And then all the way at the other end of the spectrum, he came up with the slogan of Good Charm as he was diagnosed. He did not have much longer to live. He wanted to make sure that the rest of us carried on his work. And he gave a speech and he basically said, if you see something wrong, you need to do something. You need to get in trouble. You know, shape things up. Maybe be good trouble. So everybody has kind of embraced that slogan. And so you'll see a lot of the quilts may mention the words good trouble, like that one over there on the end. And even my personal quilt, which is the bookshelf quilt, I named it Good Trouble Library because I think that all great thinkers are readers. And I tried to imagine what books he would have read that would have influenced him to change the world. And so that was the idea for my quilt. Other quilters, this one behind me, what inspired her was a poster that she had seen, and that's Rosalind's quilt. Raise your hand, Rosalind. She had seen this poster that's in the left corner
down here,
and it said hands that we had. Now, can our public officials, because he was leading a voting rights drive at the time, and so that was the jumping off point for her quilt. So all of them have a message. Brenda, where's Brenda? You're right. Oh, you sat down. Okay. Brenda did the quilt that's in the program. It's right over here on the side that you can't see from right here, of President Obama awarding Congressman Lewis the Medal of Freedom. And that has become a very famous quilt. It's right over here. And she is the one who made it. And let's see, who else do we have? We have Mary. This is her quilt. Remind me of the name.
Inheriting Good Trouble.
Okay. Inheriting Good Trouble. So he's talking to the children, passing his words of wisdom on to the next generation. And Janice has two quilts in the exhibit, and neither one is right in this place. They're on the other side. But one of them has chickens. She likes a chicken thing. And the other one is a compilation of important points in his life when he did various things, and she has a lot of pictures in her quilt. Did I miss anybody who's here right now? Because they will be happy to take a picture with you with their quilt if you so desire. But at any rate, so that's how the exhibit came together. The other thing that you'll see a lot of is the bridge, because the March Across the Edmund Meadows Bridge. And my personal favorite from a lady in Baltimore is that blue one over there. It has a zipper in it. I'm always astounded at the creativity of quilts. It has a zipper. It's named Zip It Up Racism. And if you unzip it, it says one thing. And if you zip it back up, it says something else. It's just so creative. But you have to take a close look at the zipper quilt. So all of these are original quilts, and we're hoping that it will continue to travel through 2024. And we just loved putting forth the creative effort to honor a man that we admire so much, who dedicated his life to making the world a better place. Mm-hmm. If anybody has any questions, I'm happy to try to answer.
I just came up. Okay. But I want to know about those pants.
Yeah.
Honey, those are rocking.
You know what? You are not the first one. I am wearing two hats during the festival. I am a co-founder of the Atlanta Quilt Festival, which is why I get to do this talk here. Mm-hmm. And I also am fortunate enough to have a solo exhibit of my red and white quilts,
okay,
which is down the hall, and okay, I hope you'll take a look at that. All of those red and white quilts were made by me. And so, you know, I've been planning this for months now. Well, I premiered that exhibit last year in Atlanta, and I knew I was coming here, so I've been buying red and white quilts. So I can be one with the exhibits. Everybody wants to know, did I make these pants? And I'm like, no, you too can have these pants. And I don't even get paid to say this, but just pop right in the Chico's and they got a pair in your size.
They are beautiful.
Thank you.
And you look,
actually,
it's a gorgeous outfit.
It's the first day I have worn them, and I just lucked up, walked in, looking for regular jeans, and I said, oh my God, I gotta buy these.
Very nice.
So that's why I have on. Every day of this festival, I will have on red and white. Yeah.
Beautiful.
Any other questions?
Thank you.
Thank you for stopping by. Pick up a brochure and follow us online, Atlanta Quilt Festival, especially during the summer when we have classes and, of course, the exhibit. It's just a wonderful, joyous time in Atlanta.
Okay.
In the month of August. Atlanta Quilt Festival.
All right. Well, thank you so much.
You're welcome. You're welcome.
You got one? Do you have a brochure?
No, I would like one. Thank you. I wanted to come look at the quilts up this way. This is a big stitch hand quilted. Another big stitch quilted quilt. And this quilt has some mostly machine quilted, but it does have some ties for texture in this particular section. This quilt's called Building a Windy House by Nicole Kaplan. Look at these animals over here. Cute bunny. This quilt's called Flower Ton Wonka by Stephanie Nooner. What's your channel?
MA Couture Crafting.
Okay.
Did you see me bothering? I was bothering you the other day about.
Did you?
Yeah. I was on one of your lives cutting up about the block you were doing. I wanted that. If you're doing it with an AccuQuilt group.
What's up, guys?
Not Wensleydale. That's not AccuQuilt.
It was. No, it was definitely an AccuQuilt.
Chisel?
And it was chisel. It's got the half square triangle. Yeah. With the, you talk about a sharp. You had something up on the wall. I said, my goodness. I said, I have to count that.
Well,
what's
nice to
up,
meet
everybody?
You.
It's MA Couture Crafting. Come on over and hang out. If you like 3-yard quilts, if you like Disney, if you like to be at shows, if you might even see one of your quilts. I like to go around and just celebrate quilts. So come
yes.
on over. Come on over.
Love it. Where are you from?
Los Angeles, California.
Oh, so you flew in too. I've got two friends that came and met me today this week. Carla.
Carla Ford.
Our friend.
Okay,
she
good.
Belongs, she actually belongs to me.
She belongs. Oh my goodness. Oh my goodness. Carla, you're going to be fought over.
And then I saw a gentleman, met two gentlemen.
It was Eric Oda. He also has a channel.
Yep.
You talking about. The new me from out of California?
Yeah, well,
oh, that was Jason. He's out of St. Louis. He doesn't have a channel. But I'm going to put y'all on pause.